morning. We're excited to have you here at Southside Baptist Church on April 26, 2020. This morning, we're going to be in some most exciting scripture. We're going to be in the book of Ephesians, chapter 1, verse 3, the honors of salvation. I think you'll really enjoy it today. It's a great, some great scripture that we're going to be looking at. But first, we want to let you know that we miss you and we love you. We're going to see you real soon. We have something for you this morning, though, I think you really would like. Many times we worry about and we're so concerned with all these different things that go on in the world that we fail to realize this is not our home. Our home is in heaven. And so I found a song from Mercy Me, a new song that's out. It's called Almost Home, and we'd like to play that for you right now, please. Thank you.
Are you disappointed? Are you desperate for help? You know what it's like to be tired and only a shell of yourself. But you start to believe you don't have what it takes, 'cause it's all you can do just to move, much less finish the race. Don't forget what lies ahead. Almost home, brother, it won't be long. Soon all your burdens will be gone. With all your strength, sister, run wild, run free. Hold up your head, keep pressing on. We are almost home. This road will be hard, but we win in the end, simply because of Jesus in us. It's not if, but when. So take joy in the journey, even when it feels long. Oh, find strength in each step, knowing heaven is cheering you on. We are almost home, brother, it won't be long. Soon all your burdens will be gone. With all your strength, sister, run wild, run free. Hold up your head, keep pressing on. We are almost home, almost home, almost home. Heaven to us, but make no mistake, there's still more to come. When our flesh and our bone are no longer between where we are right now and where we're meant to be.
Amen. Now, as we look at our thought for today, Christ is the only way to heaven. All other paths are detours to doom. I want to get this one really good. Do you know that there is a perfect map to heaven? The way to heaven says this. The perfect map is turn right at Calvary and keep going straight. Now let's look at Ephesians 1:3 this morning. This is Paul working right into the church at Ephesus. He says, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who hath blessed us with all," not some, "with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ." Father God, we come to you this morning. We ask you, dear Lord, to bless this sermon. Let it be your sermon and not mine, dear Lord. Let us look at Jesus and nothing else and no one else, dear Lord. For you're the only one that can get us connected to heaven and get us there, dear Lord. We love you. We pray for all of our church members, dear Lord, and all this world and the different things that are going on right now, dear Lord. We love you. Be with us today during this sermon. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Now, my friends, today, I want to look at the wonderful blessings that salvation gives us. Are you excited about your next life? There's an old church hymn that kind of goes like this. The name of it is, "Oh, That Will Be Glory." Let me kind of sing it for you a little bit, okay? When all of my labors and trials are o'er, and I am safe on that beautiful shore, just to be near my Lord I adore, will through the ages be glory for me. When by the gift of his infinite grace, I am accorded in heaven a place, just to be there and to look on his face, will through the ages be glory for me. Friends will be there I have loved long ago. Joy like a river around me will flow. Yet just a smile from my Savior I know will through the ages be glory for me. Oh, that will be glory for me, glory for me, glory for me, when by his grace I shall look on his face. That will be glory for me. Oh, brothers and sisters, there's so many blessings and doctrine in the old hymns. May we never put them aside for our modern contemporary music, but let us, as we saw the first one, I love them both, let us praise God with both styles today. I love them both so very much. So our verse this morning speaks of some of the glory and honor of the redeemed. We, the ones that have made a life-changing, lifestyle-changing, language changing, morals decision changing decision to follow Jesus Christ as our Lord and our Savior. We are the redeemed, redeemed from our former lives of slavery to Satan's influence into a glorified life of love and service to our Lord Jesus Christ. Redeemed means something we achieve through atonement. We as sinners before Christ are the property of Satan through sin. And Jesus Christ redeemed us by dying on the cross for our sins. He is the atonement. He atoned. He is the payment for our sins. He's the ransom to redeem us from Satan's power and his control. Thus, through the salvation experience, our trusting Jesus as Lord and Savior, we are now allowing Jesus' crucifixion to redeem us to the freedom and freedom from the bondage of sin, and his resurrection frees us from death or eternity in hell. It doesn't get any better than that. Now, if that doesn't make you want to stand up and cheer, I have no idea what will. We're talking today about heavenly joy, way beyond this earth. Nothing that's going on here. You're never going to find true joy here on earth. Oh, you might have some fun and things, but you're never going to find true biblical life-changing, everlasting life-changing joy. So first, let's look at our scriptures. It says, the praise for the honor. Blessed be God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who hath blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places. Understand that, heavenly places. You may want to underline that in your Bible. In Christ, in Christ. Now, the first thing we must always remember is that this gives all the credit, not some of the credit, all the credit to God from whence these honors come. The word translated blessed and the other two blessing words that come from the Greek word related words for which we get our word eulogy. Let's go back now and look at, I want to read our same scripture here this morning in the Amplified version. I'm sorry, I was going to read that earlier for you, but I kind of got excited and went on. So if we can get the Amplified version up there. Thank you, Judy. Great job up back there. May blessings, praise, laudation, and eulogy be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Messiah, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual given by the Holy Spirit blessing in the heavenly realm. In the heavenly realm. That's some exciting stuff. Very exciting stuff. So today, by trusting Jesus as our Lord and Savior, we have always kind of associated the word eulogy for funerals. We give a eulogy at the funeral for the different things that they've done and different things like that, and kind of a praise and honor for the dead. But here in Scripture, it is used in regards to our salvation, our freedom from Satan, our freedom to have eternal life in God, with God, for eternity. First, in this verse, the apostle praises the one who has given us praise and honor through the salvation experience. We did not earn salvation on our merit, and all the honor we get from salvation must be credited to the Heavenly Father. An honor, or any honor that we get in salvation, is given to us from God, so he is appropriately, I want to say, praised as the source of our honor. Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. So as I read it here this morning, we believers have no bragging rights to our salvation, as if it's something we should get credit for. All the blessings, did you hear me? All the blessings go to the creator of blessings, God himself. And we see in the Bible that there's only one way to get through to God and receive salvation, and that is through Jesus Christ. The place of the honors, the place. Bless us with all spiritual blessings, where? In heavenly places, in heavenly places. So now, this most exciting scripture we are looking at this morning, we find the place of honor, and we find the place of blessing, which indicates the very character of God. To bless us totally beyond our thought process in heaven. We will receive honors and blessing, not here on earth, but in heaven. These things are just temporal. They're just temporary. What lasts is in heaven. Stop trying to find your heaven here on earth. You never will. Heaven is being prepared for those who trust and obey Jesus as Lord and Savior. This is in the future. not here on earth. Our glory is coming round the corner when she comes. We can see it now, or we cannot see it now. We can't even begin to imagine how great it is going to be for those that trust Jesus now. It's a holy place. Spiritual blessings that we're going to get. Our honors are spiritual ones. They're given in the spiritual place in our lives. Until you have a spiritual existence, though, with Jesus Christ, you have not even begun to live. Now, this kind of talk confuses and disappoints the carnal world who sees little value in spiritual things. A truly spiritual life only happens when a person gives their heart and their soul to Jesus Christ. Remember, Jesus said, and I'm using Amplified Version here because it really knocks it out of the park, in John 14, 17, I'll read you the Amplified Version. It says, "The Spirit of truth, who the world cannot receive, welcome, take it to its heart, because it does not see him or know and recognize him." In other words, the world does not take Jesus Christ to heart. They think he's just a temporary thing. They think he's just fake. Most of them don't even believe in Jesus nowadays. But Jesus is the only way, the truth, and the life. And this one says, it says, very few, the temporal world does not welcome him in their heart because it does not see him. They don't see him or know and recognize him as we do who have accepted Jesus as our Lord and Savior and allowed the Holy Spirit to come live inside of us. But you know and recognize him. Hallelujah, believers. You know and recognize him. For he lives where? With you. Constantly. When? Constantly. Not yesterday, not tomorrow. Right now. All the time. No matter what you're going through, he is constantly with you right now. And will be in you. Wow, what a great scripture. What a great scripture. I hope you copy that bad boy down, John 14, 17. You see, the carnal thinking mind, without the Holy Spirit, wants honor and favors in the material world right here and right now. It's the you only live once attitude, the lost way of thinking attitude, the you only go around once attitude, the get all the gusto here and now attitude. Carnal or lost thinking does not appreciate spiritual blessings. Wise individuals value spiritual honors above all earthly honors. And that be us. That's us, you and I, believers who have trusted Jesus as our Lord and Savior. Our treasure is not here. Our treasures are in heaven. It says, blessed us with all spiritual blessings. Where? In heavenly places. Please understand that. In heavenly places. Our honors are in heaven. Now, I'm not the sharpest knife in the drawer, but I seem to detect something really cool here. Heavenly places does not mean that heaven is going to have a place. It's going to have more than one place. It says places. It's plural. There's going to be lots of stuff in heaven to keep us looking like surprised and excited tourists for probably at least, I figure, the first 1,000 years. That word places excites me. Let your mind drift to dreamland right now. And just think about the wonderful places God has in store for us that love him. And the greatest thing is that none of us have even the slightest clue of how great it is going to be for you and for I who have trusted Jesus as our Lord and Savior. Whoa, Pete, there. That makes my toes curl. I get so excited sometimes that my heart starts pumping so much that it pulls up the mole nerves and stuff that all my toes curl underneath. I get real excited about Jesus Christ. I pray today you're having a toe curling experience for Jesus. Think about it. Heavenly places. The Man of the Year honor given by Time magazine is given on earthly places. All the honors the world gets excited about are given in earthly places. The honors for salvation are given in heavenly places. If you feel trampled on and disrespected in this life, cheer up. The next life will be filled with great honors from God in heavenly places. Now, the next thing, the prerequisite, it's a big old fancy word, for the honors. Prerequisite. In other words, what does it take to gain all the heavenly blessings that God is preparing for us? He puts it right in. The answer is right there in the scriptures, and we're going to look at it right now. This is the coolest part of all. This verse this morning has it all. I love it. In Christ. In Christ. You must be in Christ. I love it. No one single that has a single honor except Jesus Christ. No one will come to those honor to those who do not see Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. You want the honors, you must go through Jesus Christ. These great eternal honors are reserved only for those in Christ. The scripture's right there. Read it. You must be in many things, but the only in that counts is Jesus Christ. The world tries to gain honors by everything except in Christ. There's much hostility to Christ in the world, but He is the way to heavenly honors. Leave out Christ and you leave out our honors from God. Christ is the only way of salvation, and thus He is the only way to these honors which we get from the salvation. As Charles H. Gabriel, the one who wrote that song, said, "When by His grace I shall look on His face, that will be glory. Be glory for me." Do you want that glory in your heart today? Do you want freedom from sin and the sins that are keeping you a prisoner to Satan? Then trust Jesus as your Lord and your Savior. And then you can claim this verse for yourself, like all the ones that have already trusted the saving grace of Jesus Christ. I claim this verse for myself because I have given my life and my soul to Jesus Christ and His saving grace. As the scripture says, "Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who hath blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus." That is a most powerful scripture. Stop fighting, please. Trust Jesus as your Lord and your Savior today. You may have been going to church for years, but you've never truly trusted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You may have went through all kinds of different rituals that the church makes you do, but was your heart really in it? Jesus says, "I want to have a personal relationship with you, not a religious experience. I want a personal relationship." And of course, first of all, is this: everyone is a sinner and is separated from God. Romans 3:23. "For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God." And second, God loves us so much that He gave His Son to die for our sins. Romans 5:8. "But God commended His love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us." You see in a kind of a red line that goes right through there? Christ is in it all. He's the only way. And the third, death means separation forever from God. Eternal life comes through trusting Jesus Christ. Romans 6:23 explains that. "For the wages," your payment, your reward for sin, is death, eternal separation from God. "But the gift, the free gift of God, is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord." And then fourth, in order to begin your new life in Christ, you must be saved. Simple word means you're saved from going to hell, saved to go to heaven. Very simple word. You must believe that Jesus died for your sins and declare him and accept him as your Lord and your Savior. Romans 10:9. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth and believe in thine heart. It's not a head thing. It's a heart thing. You change your heart, you're going to change your life. That God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. Saved from going to hell, saved to the rewards of heaven. And then fifth, this is God's promise to you. If you accept Jesus, he will accept you. Romans 10:13. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And with that, let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father God, we come to you today. We ask you, dear Lord, that your spirit will move into the homes, into the iPhones, the iPads, the computers, the televisions, wherever this is being seen, dear Lord, that your penetrating word will touch someone's heart that's watching this. If they've never accepted Jesus as their Lord and Savior, we pray right now, dear Lord, that the Holy Spirit will draw them to a saving grace knowledge of Jesus. You can say yes to Jesus Christ right now, right where you're at. You don't have to be in a church. Actually, the Bible says wherever you're at, that's where church. If you're believing in Jesus and loving him, where two or three are gathered together in my name, that's where I'm at. But he wants to come into your heart right now. And we're asking you to trust Jesus Christ as your Lord and your Savior. And with that, there's a sinner's prayer that we can pray. And if you want to trust Jesus as your Lord and Savior, the prayer is just this prayer of celebration, of acknowledgement, and a praise for God for saving your soul. The prayer kind of goes like, dear Jesus, I'm sorry that I'm a sinner. I know I have sinned and I've sinned against you and I've sinned against my whole life I've been a sinner. And I want to accept you as my Lord and my Savior. And I'm trusting the Lord and believing that you were born of a virgin, that you lived a sinless life because you were the perfect Lamb of God who came to take away the sins of the world. And you died on Calvary's mountain to take away my sins. And 3 days later, you rose again and you conquered death. That's the whole ball of wax right there, Lord. And I'm trusting you as my Lord and Savior today. And dear Lord, we pray that somebody trusted you today as their Lord and Savior. And we pray, dear Lord, for the church today, dear Lord, that everybody that's watching will realize, dear Lord, that our heavenly place, our rewards are not here. They are in heavenly places. And our home is in the heavenly place. So help us and give us comfort. Let us maybe be concerned about what's going on, but not be so worried, because we know we're almost home. We love you, Jesus, with all of our hearts and our soul. And God, thank you for sending your son to die on the cross for our sins. Thank you, dear Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. May God bless you.